Hey, what is going on, guys? Over at Stealth here, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at how pro and high elo players are playing Lilia after her release. So taking a look at key combos, tips and tricks, best builds, runes. So with that being said, let's get into it. So if we start things off here by taking a look at a couple key combos, honestly, Lilia doesn't have too many super intricate combos in her kit, but a really important one you need to know for when you do hit level 6, this is gonna be your like your bread and butter, full all-in combo. You wanna use your Q on the opponent to proc your passive, then use your ultimate, and then after that, you use your E and your W. Your E and your W are skill shots, right? So they're a little bit more difficult to land, but if you use them after the enemy is ulted, it's going to guarantee your E and your W hit because the enemy is going to be asleep. They won't be able to move at all. So this is going to be the combo you want to use if you want to all in the opponent or you just want to be able to guarantee that all of your abilities hit. Now, when you're ganking with the champion in the early game, you can look to lead with your E so that you can get the slow off on the opponent. And then after that, you can look to use your Q and your W. If your teammate does have some sort of hard CC, you always want to try to wait until they land that ability and then you use your W. So if you're ganking for something like a Leona or a Nautilus down bot lane, then always try and wait for that hook to connect or that or the stun to connect from Leona and then look to use your W. Because if you do that, you're just going to have a lot more max damage and you're going to be able to finish off kills a lot easier. A combo you can look to use when ganking at level 6 or just in general throughout the game is you can look to Q flash onto the opponent and then use your ultimate. So if you're coming in for a gank and you want to guarantee a multi-man ultimate on the opponent, then you can just look to Q flash, get an instant proc of your passive off on both of the opponent and then use your ultimate, lock them down. And this is just a really deadly gank combo or just a really deadly combo in team fights as well. If you can find the enemies grouped up and get those multi-man ultimates off, then it's going to be very impactful for you. So this is just a really quick way to do that, and it gives the enemy very little time to react. Let's move on to taking a look at a couple tips and tricks now for the champion. So whenever you base with Lilia, especially once you're level 6, just throw an E down top lane or throw an E down bot lane. I'll show you guys in the background gameplay here kind of where you need to be standing and where you need to put your cursor, but you can do this and your ultimate is global with Lilia, right? So if your E ends up hitting the enemy down bot lane, say you just throw a random E from base down bot lane, it hits the enemy AD carry, you can activate your ultimate and that can just single-handedly get your team a free kill down bot lane. Now, of course, this isn't going to happen every single game. It's probably only going to happen maybe one in every 100 games. It's not going to happen very often at all, but there's no reason not to do it, right? It's not going to cost you anything. You might as well do it every single time you base. So keep this in mind when you are playing Lilia. Another really key thing to remember when playing the champion is that when you're walking around the map and you're walking past a camp, even if you don't intend on taking that camp, you can still look to use your Q on it so that you do keep up your passive movement speed so you do get around the map faster. You'll see a really good example of this here in the background gameplay. The Lilia player is looking to finish off a kill on the enemy AD carry, and she ends up using her Q on the Krug camp to keep up her movement speed on the passive so that she can gap close onto her target quicker. And honestly, if she didn't use that Q on the Krug camp, she might have not been able to get in range to finish off that kill on the enemy AD carry. Once you hit late game with Lilia, or once you hit the mid to late game team fight stage, you can look to make some really aggressive plays with your flash. If you do end up going for a stopwatch or a Zhonya's and you see the enemy like grouped as 5 in a fight, you can look to go for a Q flash play onto the back line, then use your ultimate immediately after, get like a 5-man ultimate off, use your Zhonya's as the enemy team is drowsy so that they don't end up killing you, and then you get a 5-man sleep on the enemy team. And if you get the 5-man sleep in a mid to late game fight, chances are you're probably just gonna wipe that fight and you're gonna single-handedly win it for your team. So keep this in mind, like just grabbing a stopwatch later on, even if you don't intend to end up finishing that into a Zhonya's, can allow for you to make this really aggressive game-winning play. Now with Lilia, you can buffer both your E and your Q with flash. You can't buffer your W, you can't buffer your ultimate, obviously, but if you're trying to finish off a low health target, if they're trying to get away from you, then these are really good combos to use here with either your E or your Q to try to finish off that target. What you wanna do is you wanna use your Q and then immediately after you wanna flash, or use your E and immediately after you flash. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna cause that ability to come out as soon as your flash ends up going through. So it just gives the enemy time, a lot less time to react to your Q. And if you're trying to finish off that low health target, then it just allows for you to have the highest percent chance of you getting that kill. And then for your clear on Lilia, for your first clear, you do got options. You can do a three camp into gank, you can do a full clear. The only thing you really want to avoid is doing an early Gromp. So doing blue into Gromp isn't the best on the champion because you want to start Talisman and you really want to take advantage of that AoE damage coming out of your Q and your W. So you want to be doing Wolves, Raptors, Krugs. You don't really want to be doing that Gromp. If you do blue into Gromp, then you're just going to, it's going to take you a while. You're also going to fall low on HP. So try to stick to those AoE camps on your first clear. So now if we move on to taking a look at the best setups for the champion at the moment, we're going to start off here by taking a look at the best builds for her in the jungle. And the standard core build right now is going to be a Runic Echo Rush into Liandry's and then Rylai's. Liandry's and Rylai's are just doing really good on her right now as her two core main items, just because she is a shorter range champion. She's a shorter range AP champion. She needs to get pretty up close to deal her damage. So building these HP items like the Liandry's and the Rylai's just allows her to be more durable. The items also just synergize really well together with Lilia's kit. So this is the best build setup right now. Standard setup that if you just want a cookie cutter build for every game, you can look to run this one. Now, a lot of pros right now are actually really liking a more tanky oriented setup on their Lilia. So going for like a Dead Man's Plate as their third item there, that just adds to your ability to stay very mobile around the map, adds to your tankiness there, makes you very difficult to kill. And Lilia doesn't really have the best AP ratios on her abilities. Her biggest AP ratio in her kit is only at 40%. So going for something like a Rabadon's later on in your build just really doesn't make a ton of sense, or it just doesn't really synergize super well with Lilia. So you'll see a lot of players right now going for a Dead Man's, going for a Spirit Visage, Abyssal Mass. So this tanky setup on the Lilia does do very well in solo queue, and it's also what a lot of pros are doing. And then for your solo lane Lilia, if you're either playing her in the top lane or in the mid lane, then the best builds right now are very similar to what you'd go in the jungle. You obviously don't go Runic Echoes, but going for a Liandry's Rush into Rylai's and then Dead Man's is really good. A lot of players right now are going for Rod of Ages as the rush item on Lilia, but this doesn't perform very well in solo queue. Most pros right now, if they're playing lane Lilia, they are going for a Liandry's Rush. They're not going for that Rod of Ages. So if you are somebody who is building that Rod of Ages as your starting item right now, then I would look to try out the Liandry's into Rylai's and just completely avoiding that Rod of Ages as your starting item. Now, you might try to argue that you need to go Rod of Ages on Lilia because if you don't, then you're going to run into mana issues, but this is completely nullified by the fact that you can go for Presence of Mind in your runes there. You're going to go Conquer, which we'll talk about a little bit here on your Lilia. So if you do find yourself running into mana issues, you don't need that Rod of Ages. You can just go Presence of Mind and you will be completely fine. Now, looking at the best rune pages going around on Lilia, for jungle Lilia, there's two different pages at the moment. It's either the Dark Harvest or the Conquer. A lot of players are going for Phase Rush as well, but it seems to be just a little bit overkill on the pick because you already got like a lot of movement speed built into your kit with Lilia. So the Phase Rush and going like Nimbus Cloak just seems to be a little bit overkill at the moment. So Dark Harvest is her best page right now, best win percent page. It's also the page that a lot of pros are going for. If you do want a little bit more dueling threat in the early game though, Conquer is very good on the pick. You stack this up very quickly on Lilia. It's definitely not a bad choice on her. So you can look to experiment with both pages on the champion. Both are pretty good, but Dark Harvest does tend to perform a little bit better. And then if you are looking to play Lilia in the solo lane, especially up in the top lane, then Conquer is just going to be the number one best keystone for you. Super good on Lilia because you get four stacks of Conquer whenever you do use an ability. If you use your Q on the opponent, your Q is going to give you two stacks, and then your passive is also going to give you two stacks there. So it allows you to stack this up very quickly. You can get to max stacks pretty easily on your Lilia, and it just gives you some really good dueling potential there for the laning phase, especially if you're going up against like a melee champion. If you're going up against a melee top laner who doesn't have a gap closer in their kit, then you can just look to use your passive really well to kite them around, and with your full stacks of Conquer, you can do a really good job at out-dueling them in the laning phase. And then for your ability maxing on Lilia, you want to be maxing your Q out first, your W second, and then your E last. At level one, you want to take your Q, no matter if you're playing her in the top lane or in the jungle. Level two, same thing, you want to take your W there. And then at level three, you can take your Q or your E depending on the situation. So if you're playing jungle Lilia and you're looking to do a full clear, you're not looking to gank until level four, then you can look to put a second point into your Q there at level three to allow yourself to have a better jungle clear. Same thing for in the top lane, if you're playing a top lane Lilia and the enemy is not really giving you an opportunity to ever land an E on you, if they're like standing in the minion wave the whole time, if it doesn't look like you're gonna be able to hit an E on the opponent at level 3, then you can look to put a second point into your Q there. So it does kind of depend on the situation. It's gonna change every single game, so keep that in mind when you do hit level 3 on Lilia. And then lastly here, if we run down some of Lilia's weakest matchups, some of her best bans for this patch at the moment. First, for in the jungle, three bans I would definitely highly consider would be Kha'Zix, Kindred, and Rengar. Kha'Zix is very good into Lilia because he has point and click damage, so you can't dodge out on any of his damage by using your movement speed from your Q with Lilia. She does tend to thrive more in matchups to where she can look to dodge out on skill shots with her passive movement speed from her Q. Also, Lilia is very skill shot reliant. Her Q, her W, and her E are all skill shots, so with a champion like Kha'Zix or Kindred or Rengar, they all have gap closers in their kit, so it's very easy for those kind of champions to dodge out on Lilia's damage and make her kind of useless for the most part. And then as for top lane Lilia, she does struggle against very similar picks. So champions that can just get right on top of her, that have gap closers, and that can just CC her, burst her out. So picks like Riven do very well into Lilia top. Same thing with Aurelia, Fiora. So she does tend to do a lot better into these like melee picks that don't have gap closers, like tankier top lane picks. She does do pretty well into Ornn, into Poppy, Sion, Malphite. Those kind of picks, she does tend to have much more success against. Alright, so that is going to be all for the video, guys. Hopefully you did enjoy, hopefully you did learn something from this video that you can look to take into your future games with Lilia. So with that being said, if you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to drop a like and subscribe if you have yet to already. So thanks for watching, have an awesome day, and I will see you in my next video.